to explain in the ins and outs of FBX exportation, but a simple mesh like this, boned with two bones, should easily go into UDK. If it doesn't, we'll do it as an ActorX, but I prefer this format anyway. Right, where's my UZI file gone? Try meshes. Scenes, maybe it's in scenes under UDK here. Yes. Oh, I've got so many different sub-directories, I've got to start putting them all in the same place. It's so confusing. Okay, we'll just go with that. Now what we do is we open UDK again and we import that in into a new package, which I will call Weapon 5, I think. I'll just quickly check on that. UDK game, content, my packages. As you can see, I've got loads of sub-levels in my package directories. Yeah, Weapon 5 mesh. So we'll get a similar name and then just change the last digit. So, right, where are we? Weapon 4 mesh. Rocket launcher, I'll quickly show you that. There we go, haven't textured it yet. I've got the texture, I've made it. Boom! Oh, it's the wrong way around anyway. Yeah, there's the old sights. So, what am I doing? Right, import that Uzi. It was in 3DS Max, wasn't it? Yep. Scenes. UDK. Uzi. FBX, okay. Weapon 5 mesh, we want to change that to. And do okie dokie and then let it ride in. And we'll check that that's not died or doesn't look a complete catastrophe in a moment. Because sometimes you do get these odd problems with FBX. But like I said, a simple mesh, it doesn't really have much trouble with its characters that it really messes up. Oh no, I don't believe it. Can you believe it? Oh god. Well there you go, me and my big mouth. The UDK just crashed. Come on, stop. Just don't sit there for 4 hours waiting to close. Right, let's try it one more time. Could have just been a fluke. What we'll do is we'll save this as well and then we'll shut Max for the moment because we can always reopen that in a minute in case it was some sort of conflict of problems. Right, back down into weapons again. Import. Documents, 3DS Max, scenes, UDK, Uzi. Yeah, it's unusual for it to crash doing that. Now if it crashes again now, I'm not going to try and import it as FBX again. I'll go to ActorX. It could just be the amount of triangles. Now it's not normally a factor. This is where it crashed last time. Yep, now there's an error with the file. Oh, fuck's sake. Stupid bloody thing. Right. End process. Ah. I'm going to try it. I said I wouldn't try and export it again. I'm going to try one more thing. I think I am. No, I didn't. Forget it. I'm just going to do it as an ActorX because it will go in. It would just be a bit more hassle. Yeah. Come on. See, I shouldn't have shut max, really. Ah, not too bad. Right, open UDK. Uzi. Oh, it's not in there, is it? It's in outside the directory. Uzi 2, open. Right, get up ActorX. Change the mesh file name to Uzi. And then the browse the directory where you want to save it. So I'm going to save it in my Uzi directory. And then select the whole thing. See what we've got, boxes we've got checked here. Yeah, that'll do nicely. And then what we'll do is we'll try and save the mesh reference pose. If it says yep, it's worked perfectly. I can always tell by that second checkbox coming up. So let's try and get it into UDK now, because that doesn't mean it's going to go into UDK just because the PSK is written. Sometimes, you know, it's something to do with the mesh. Right, I'm just going to import it in rather than finding that directory for the moment. 3ds Max Scenes UDK Uzi PSK. Okay, I'll change the package name in a moment. If it works, that is. It's about here. It crashed last time, isn't it? It may well... Oh, you know what I haven't done? I haven't changed the bone names. It worked that time. Let's have a quick look at it. Yeah, there's one Uzi. Dodgy material ID. Do you remember I showed that there were those red bits on the texture? That's why it's become invisible around the silencer. So what we're going to do here to get rid of that problem, we'll go back into modify, we will delete that, and we won't delete the skin. Whoops. See if we can go up. No, we can't rise above. No, we'll try and go back into edit poly mode. No, this isn't going to work, I don't think, simply because the bone's too long. We'll try it anyway. Element. Get rid of the silencer. Press delete on the keyboard. Right, delete. Oh god, look at the state of it. Delete. Right, and we've got a little stumpy Uzi now. Or as they normally are, they don't normally have silencers on them. Right, shut that out, go back into skin. Now this will probably all mess up now, let's just quickly... No. Undo move. Wireframe. Seems alright. That bone should hopefully be invisible in the game. We'll see anyway. Right, back onto the mesh. Unwrap again, edit, face. I don't know why that's all moved out of there. Map, flatten mapping by material IDs, okay. Right, so let's see what's what here. I think we've only got, oh, we have still got two IDs, it's just a trigger. Sorry, the magazine and the stock here, different colours. Right, tools, render UVW template, normal, render, the magazine's going to be all transparent in places as well, but at the moment I don't care, just want to get this in. Yeah, so we've overwritten that original UV render. Right, let's pull down max, shut this for a minute, no, raise max again, back into utilities, actor X, and then resave the mesh reference pose. Okay, and then we go re-import that into UDK. See, it's much quicker now about that silencer anyway. That's probably what messed it up on the FBX. Where is it? Ah. It's way off now. Don't know why that's happening. Look, it's way away from there, so... God almighty. Try and choose the bone. Zero that out again. Right, now save mesh reference pose yet again. Okay. Oh, bloody hell. And again, for the 400th time. And re-import it again. Now hopefully it should be better centered now. Yep, there we go. See, a little bit messing about and we're in an Uzi. Oh, I don't like that. It should have a hollow barrel. Oh, God. I'm not going to bother redoing it again. Right, so... I'm going to quickly check something, see if hollowing the barrel is possible at a later date. No. Well, it is, I mean, but just not simply. See, if we were to go into edit poly, yes. Choose polygon then. And there happens to be, oh God. Oh, forget what I'm doing here anyway, I'm just testing this out. Right now, yeah, that's the barrel there. We'll just quickly extrude that. We'll go inset. Yeah, we can, we can extrude it. Yeah, I should have done that to start with, but I didn't bother checking it. So, we could have had a hollow barrel, but I'm not going to bother with that now. I can't be asked. Go back into the unwrap UVW. I'm going to delete it temporarily from this file, because it has to be redone again now that I've moved some polygons. And what we'll do is we will go zoom extensor, and again pick the mesh, do it again. Don't know why that's not zooming that there. Ah, it's because the bone's on it, isn't it? See, this thing's not silly. Oh, max. Unhide all. See, there's the old bone sticking out. Right, we'll save that, and then I can come back in at some other date and, redo the UV. I mean, as you saw, it only takes a few minutes. Save file again and again, because I'm not sure if it's saved then. Right, we're not going to bother applying a texture, because the important thing about this is importing a gun and using it. Right, the bone names, can we change those? Show bones, hide bones, set bones, section, selection color, copy bone name to clipboard. No, I want to rechange the bloody bone name. Oh, bollocks. I can't believe there is no function for that in here. Because I'm not going to be able to get it to work with the code. I'll show you the reason why. Let's open up another one. The bones have to be named after Epic Bones here for it to be able to use the Epic code. Oh, that's my rocket launcher. Pistol. AK-47. Yeah, we've got to, as you can see, got to give it the Epic names, because we're using Epic code for these weapons, and they are extended from the shock rifle. I'll quickly show you the classes that you'll need. So, in UDK, go into Development SRC, and you'll need to create your own classes if you don't know this already about importing a weapon. So my package of classes is called Dave Saxon Classes, and then that's it says M16 because this also works with the M16 gun, but as you can see here, the skeletal mesh is an AK-47, and the anims are as well. So this is the shock rifle code. That's why it's got the shock ball and little references here and there to the shock rifle itinerary. But wherever it references the actual mesh, I've replaced it with my weapon. Now, I'm not going to go over this because I'm going to have to get this into another tutorial, and I'll upload that after this one. What you need to do in these three codes, because you not only need the actual weapon code, which was the shock, this would have been UT shock rifle, weapon shock rifle, you need an ammo class and an attachment class, and it doesn't matter whatever you name them. I'll show you tomorrow where to get them actually, and then how to extend from them. It's pretty simple stuff. So I'll see you then. Bye.